Okay, I would like to show you guys how we can use the disk method to prove the formula for the volume of a cone being 1/3 pi r squared h. Here we go. First, let me just show you guys a picture for a cone. This is how we like to draw it, right? Circular base and then the height. Right here, let's say the radius is r and the height is h. So that will have the volume 1/3 pi r squared h. But if you look at this picture and do a rotation about the y-axis, the integration and also the setup will be a little bit more difficult. It will be easier if you turn this sideways like the following. So start with a cone like this, right? Still same thing, but here the radius is r and the h becomes like the horizontal distance right here, which is still the height, right? Let's look at this picture and think about how we can come up with a rotation that will give us this right here. The answer for that is we need to have a line right here and do the rotation about the x-axis. So let's go ahead, put down a picture. Start with a line like this. I don't know the equation yet, but don't worry, we'll figure that out. Now, here's the deal. From here to here is the height, so this right here will be labeled as h, and then from here to here is r, so that right there will be r. Right, so we're looking at this region and we are going to rotate this about the x-axis, and as a result this is what we are going to get. Go ahead and draw this right here, and then just on the bottom just do a mirror image, and then at the end just do like an oval. So that's how you can come up with a solid of revolution, and then put back the x-axis and then put back the y-axis to make it look like really three-dimensional. Anyway though, firstly let's come up with the equation for this first. It's just a line. Good thing is the y-intercept here is zero, right? That's why if you start with this cone it's easier. Otherwise you have to figure out the y-intercept, not so good. How about now the slope though? Well, the slope is just how far you go up and then how far you go to the right, right? So we go up r times and then we move to the right h times. So the equation is just r over h times x. So that's the equation for that. Now, take a look at this. For this picture, we are going to do a vertical disk. So I will draw a picture right here for you guys like this. And you might be wondering why a vertical disk. Because if you want to find the area of this region by using rectangles, because for integration, you technically will start with a vertical rectangle. And then if you rotate this vertical rectangle, then you can get a disk that sits like vertically. All right, now let's do a labeling. This right here is just a small change in the x, a little bit of x. Denote that by dx. And then the radius here will be from here to here is the vertical distance, which is just a y. It's pretty much the same labeling here. This right here is just a little bit of x, and this right here is just the y value. You go from the x-axis up to the curve. That's the y value. All right, let's focus on this picture because area is not the deal today. We want to find the volume. So right here, I'm just going to put this down. Volume is equal to the following. First, we are going to find out the volume of this red disk. It's just pretty much a cylinder, very, very thin cylinder. All we have to do is pi r squared times the thickness. So we have the pi and the r, we have the h. Sorry, r is the y, square that, and then the thickness is dx. This right here is technically like a little dv, a little bit of the volume. But if you want the whole volume, just go ahead and integrate it. You see, if you integrate dv, you get a v back. So all the notations, you know, make sense. Perfect. Now, we are in the x world. So we have to know x goes from what to what. Look at the x-axis, it goes from 0 to h, right? It goes from 0 to h. So 0 to h. That's pretty much a setup. Except what? Y is not allowed in the x world. But okay, because we know y is equal to r over x. Sorry, r over h times x. So let's just focus on the integration now. Going from 0 to h, we have the pi, and the y is r over h times x, and then we square that, and then we have the dx. Let's put all the constants on the outside. Firstly, we have the pi. Secondly, r and h are the constants in this situation as well. R squared can be gone outside. Likewise, h squared can also be going on the outside. So that's what we have. All together, these three things, outside and the squares. And now for the inside, we just have the integral going from 0 to h, and we're looking at x squared dx. Now, integrate this, add 1 to the power, we get 3, and divide it by the new power. Ah, this is how we end up with the 1/3. In fact, a cone is like a 1/3 of a cylinder. It's really just a 1/3 of a cylinder, because that's the formula for the cylinder. By the way though, for the integration, let's just finish it. The 3 can also be going to the front on the bottom. So we have pi r squared over 3h. And then inside here, we just have x squared. So x to the 3rd power. And then we have to go from 0 to h. All right, putting h here. So in the front, we have pi r squared over 3h times h to the 3rd power. And we should also put in 0, but putting 0 is just 0, so it doesn't matter. Now, simplify this a little bit. Oops, here we have the h squared, sorry. Well, simplify this. H squared and this cancel, we have one more left. So ladies and gentlemen, we do have the 1/3 pi r squared, and then we have the h to the 1st power right here. And that is the volume of a cone right here.